Okay, kids, ladies, gentlemen, boys, girls, any pets at home? We are in downtown Nashville on Music Row. I just got home, like literally an hour ago. I had a really early flight at 6 in the morning from Wisconsin back to Nashville from my experience of touring the McPherson Guitar Factory and getting to meet all of the incredibly talented and sweet people that built my guitar. And they were so nice and overnighted my guitar back to Nashville so I can pick it up this morning so that I didn't have to fly with it, which is so nice. And I'm so excited.
Everybody get up.
I can't even talk right now because I'm so excited. But my guitar is done, and we have Larry over here to thank. Oh my gosh! Larry, turn around, show him your jacket. You're seeing guitars. Okay.
By the way, was it your producer, Michael, that you were borrowing his guitar? What was the story? And that's
stealing is more
stealing?
Of a correct word to use.
So
yes.
He had one, and you were like, can I use that? And then you thought, can I use that some more? And
yes. Well, the first time, of course, it was, may I use
sure.
that? Can I use that?
Mm-hmm.
Then after I played it, I'm like, there. You can't go back. Like, I'm not even like, when you play this thing, you cannot go back to any other kind of guitar. And I had to borrow, quote unquote,
sure.
for my writing sessions.
Uh-huh.
And then and it's so beautiful too, like this unique look that it has. I needed it for my photo shoot. So
yeah.
I mean, how cool is this dude? He trusted me with his guitar. I had a photo shoot out in the woods, and of course I guarded it with my life.
Right.
But that's how I know he like legit thinks that I'm a real good friend.
Sure.
He trusted me with his McPherson guitar in the woods.
That is a pretty big deal. And
there's
now
a lot
you've
of
got
sticks everywhere.
Now you've got one of your own.
I got one of my own. I don't need to steal his anymore.
Is that like surreal or is it not surreal? It's all surreal. Pinch me, I have been pinched. I've seen it in movies.
I forgot to tell you that before we walked all the way to the front. Little minor detail. I gotta go to the bathroom. You know what it is? I had two grande Starbucks already. You got your keys? I gotta get my phone to text the guy that I'm here because it's a recording studio and I don't want to interrupt the session because this is supposed to be happy. For real, I got to go to the bathroom. So, I'm so excited. Got my guitar, just picked it up, and I scored a pair of sunglasses too. These were here like a month and a half ago when I came by, and I was like, dude, if no one claims these in 30 days, they're mine. No one claimed them, so I took them. Let me take it out of the case in daylight so you can see it. Drum roll. You ready? Here we go. Hello. A rose, which is the flower that's on my mother's gravestone. And then a heart up here on the back of the headstock with the date that my mother passed away, which is March 29th, 2007. The little heart. Got koa wood, ebony binding, bear claw wood on the front, some more ebony binding over the sound hole. And gosh, I'm just so excited, so blessed, and so lucky and thankful. Thank you, McPherson Guitars. Thank you, Larry and Lori Klink. Without you guys, this bad boy would not have happened. So I need to be more sincere with my glasses off. Thank you. I'm waiting for somebody to say April Fools, and I'd be like, it's December.